But whose job is it in Tibet to milk the yaks?
I know who cleans the hooves.
Who's that?
Yaksmiths.
Yaksmiths. Yaksmiths.
Yeah. The milkman. The milk. Is there a milkman? That's a milkman.
Oh no, there is no milkman.
Do they have milk? Is it nice?
Tibet smells of butter, they say. There's butter everywhere. The trick part of it is that the yak is the male of the species. So nobody milks a yak.
What's a female called?
The nak, oddly enough.
The nak.
A nak or a dri.
One of the things I really remember Tibet and about yaks too, they make sculptures, apparently.
They do.
It's every year
religious,
there's a festival of these sculptures made out of buttermilk. And there's apparently a guy in the 20s, who's a famous surrealist Buddhist sculptor, actually made a yak out of buttermilk.
Wow.
Which he was able to milk and made another, even larger.
How tall is a wild yak?
I think enormous.
Yeah, I'm going 6 feet.
Yeah.
6'5", my height, in fact.
Yeah, I'm going to say 4 foot.
Well, that would be a domesticated yak.
I'm going to say 9, maybe 10 foot.
I've already told you that it's 6'5".
I think it's about 15 foot.
I'm so glad I was never your teacher. I really am. But yeah, you're right.
20 foot, sir.
Aside from their meat and all their milk products, particularly the yogurt and the butter and the cheese, they have the longest hair of any animal, the yak. It's 2 foot long. And it was used for
wigs.
In the 17th century. Wigs, your periwig, your Charles II style wig. And in fact, the BBC wig store, we checked, still has quite a large number of yak wigs. And if you're going to play Santa at Christmas, then the chances are your beard will be yak.
Couldn't we introduce the yak to Britain?
I don't see why not. I mean, they are rather specialised for the altitudes in Tibet.
If you introduce them to Britain, they'd blow up. It's a huge, incredible sight. Why not? Or we could have yaks dangling from balloons. The altitude would be right.
Fantastic.
It could.
I love the idea.
Have a hot air balloon. Come up to see the yak fields. 5,000 feet up. And they still graze on what air?
They'd have to be up there because their blood cells are half the size, but they have twice as many.
So actually, when they came down to sea level, they'd be immensely powerful.
Like Terence Stamp in Superman 2.
Very much like that.
Yeah. Kneel before Zod.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.